2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
And those are the starting lineups. Lots of interesting matchups tonight. Stick around. We'll be right back with more.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Tonight, it'll be the Portland Trail Blazers up against the Detroit Pistons. For Detroit, they come into this game following a loss to the Bucks. That game was a shootout. Defense will be the key tonight for them to bounce back with a win. And this Portland team, they've been led by their star backcourt of Lillard and McCollum. Shaq, can two guards win you a championship?
You know, most title teams have a dominant wing and or a dominant big. I don't think you can win playing with two guards. It's like playing 2-on-5. Never get done.
No, but think about this. Golden State almost did it in 2015.
But they had another
Clay
guy.
And Steph.
But they had another
no,
guy.
No, Draymond's not a big.
Oh, stop it.
Draymond's
played
only
big.
6'7".
He played big.
No, 6'7". Lillard and McCollum. They might need some more high-level talent around them, but they could do it.
That's going to do it for us for now as we send you to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the 2K Sports crew.
Hi and welcome everyone here on 2K Sports. Can't wait to get some NBA action going. I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by Chris Webber and Greg Anthony. David Aldridge is our sideline reporter. DA, it's all yours.
Blazers coach Terry Stotts had previous head coaching stints in Atlanta and Milwaukee, but it was as an assistant coach in Dallas, where he helped win the 2011 title, that he rejuvenated his career. Stotts wasn't sure he'd get another coaching opportunity, but after that, he said the stars aligned. Kevin, he's now in year 8 as head coach in Portland.
The players love him. Thank you, David. And here's a look at some numbers for Lillard.
And it's striking how much his three-point shooting has improved this month. His long-range percentage is coming up, and it's going to give them a lift as a team. You can never have enough reliable threats from beyond the arc.
And now the opening lineup for Detroit. Maker out there with Dumboya. And it's Rose. Then there's Tony Snell. And it's Mikhailiuk in at the shooting guard position. And for Portland, they've got Anthony, also Whiteside out there, Trevor Ariza out there with McCollum, and it's Simons in at the point guard position. Long season, Chris, talk about the challenges of maintaining focus and concentration throughout these 82 regular season games.
I mean, the season just wears on you. First of all, physically, the travel, the games, the practice. So one, you have to get through it physically, so take care of your body. Second, mentally. Just the fact that you go through every season from Christmas to the summertime, can you just stay mentally prepared and engaged and remember what the big focus is, why all of you guys came together, the championship? So really it's just a constant reminder that you have to do the little things every day. It's not about the big picture. It's day by day until we get to the end. And usually when you keep that narrow-minded type of focus, you'll get to the end of the season and say, wow, that was quick. That was fun.
Maker passes to Mikhailiuk. They get it back. And Whiteside sends it back. Here's Simons. Oh, Whiteside in position. Hammers the alley-oop through.
And he's just always an easy target on the alley-oop. With Whiteside's size and wingspan, it's just a matter of putting the ball up there where only he can go get it.
And oh, here we go. McCollum's got it. The fast break chance. It's stolen by Rose. Up and in with the jumper near the hoop.
And Derrick Rose certainly equipped athletically to punish teams in the paint.
Little over a minute 30 into this first quarter. McCollum finds Whiteside. From 8, again the Trailblazers good for 2. The Pistons have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Outside Rose. And the layup's good off the glass.
Well, he is looking confident
Love how they're using him so far.
Yeah, that's because he's getting his number called early. I mean, he's doing his part to help carry the offensive load.
Now here's Anthony. 20 points for him last game against New Orleans.
I mean, and you look at his free throw numbers. I mean, this shows you how much pressure he put on the defense. He doesn't get the finish, but the D's got to be quicker to rotate and stop him from getting to the rim.
Dumboya, good.
And that's the role they want for Rose, getting guys going through his passing, especially when he can find them in rhythm.
Now here's McCollum. He had a 27-point outing in their last game against New Orleans.
His energy level in that game was amazing. He did all that work offensively and controlled the boards, too.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
CJ. One of the top 10 shooting guards in the NBA, CJ McCollum. I mean, you wondered, though, would he be even better lined up as a point guard? I'm not sure. But his defense has been a shortcoming. At 6'3", his size is better suited for the one.
They throw good, McCollum. See, Webb, you think about McCollum as a point guard. His assists have dropped 3 seasons running.
Yeah, Kevin, but that's because his role on this team is to score. I mean, he's so skilled. He can get other guys involved, but you want him putting it in the bucket. Who's a better option than him besides Dame Lillard? On another team, though, with a chance to start at point guard, I wouldn't mind seeing that adjustment.
And you talk about shot makers. CJ McCollum, one of the best in the game. From mid-range, you could argue he's the best, flat out. And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Yeah, very little resistance. I mean, you had to bring much faster help than that.
Now, here's Whiteside. Pulls up. Shot is good off the back rim and in. And you look at the shot chart for McCollum. He's a threat break from everywhere.
Able to hit off the bounce, pulling up. At his height, he's got to be creative, making space for his shot.
Here's Rose. He's got 6. The dish to Dumboya. Excellent D there from Anthony. For Portland, they've gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Puts it up from 12. And the shot is long.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
Here's Mikhailuk. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Rose against Anthony. Maker. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a 3-point play.
This has to help Maker's confidence, showing he has the ability to overwhelm the defense.
Detroit shooting their first free throw attempt on the night. So it's both teams making substitutions here. So they now lead by 1. Fans and broadcasters love to see teams get out and attack in transition. Would you like to see the league crack down on intentional fouls that will halt that break, slow down that break, stifle that break?
No, because the home fans or the fans of the team that's fouling doesn't want that team to get out and get an easy 2 points. I mean, we still have to have defense in the game. So anything that takes away from team scoring, you just can't say, well, we want to watch them score, don't do it. No. And very honestly, if you're an unselfish team, usually on those breaks, it's usually because a player holds the ball to the
right.
Usually they have another open player in front of them that they can pass it up to. And if you're an unselfish team, usually you still give the fans what they want. And that's a crazy highlight.
Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Henson checked in for the Pistons. Langston Galloway comes in for Derrick Rose. Here's Trent. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against New Orleans. Pass to McCollum. Portland keeps it going. A new 14-second shot clock. Here's Here's Gabriel, and Henson sends it back. Passes it to Galloway, and another turnover here by Detroit. This, of course, the first opportunity to play Portland this season.
And with this matchup being an East versus West affair, it'll be the first of only two meetings between the teams.
Yeah, should be a fun game to watch. I mean, two teams that don't see each other that much. They'll learn a lot about each other tonight.
Portland no good that time either. And here's Brown. He'll bring it up for the Pistons. This game coming after a loss against the Bucks.
And guys, there's really a fine line between being aggressive and being out of control. And in that one, they crossed the line.
Yeah, and there's really no excuse for it, GA. I mean, they know they need to play in more control.
From the arc. Galloway, no good.
Yeah, that's just a lucky break. Keep giving him that shot. Bad things will happen.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. A brief moment now to see who's atop the NBA in team free throws. Fifth best, the Trailblazers.
You know, it's really a team-wide talent. You want a foul to stop layups, but against them, you're not saving much. They'll make you pay time and again.
And the first one drops.
Very rich history for Detroit Pistons. They've been a part of the sports scene in Detroit since 1957, and they have three championships to their name.
And Brown drops them both. Well, you look back at the title teams for the Pistons. There were a lot of them. Chris, which team was your favorite?
Oh, man. Well, growing up in Detroit, I'd have to go back to the Bad Boys in 89, 90. Just watching.
It's February. Hard to believe. Let's see how the West is matching up. You look at Portland. Right now, they're on the outside looking in at the playoff seeds.
And for the Trailblazers, they've shown me some very good things this season. But that next step, those qualities that could make them true contenders, just haven't been there.
Yeah, and I'm sure they're disappointed in that. I mean, they were hoping to take that next step.
And that one, good.
Nice pass. I mean, putting in work on the interior, gotta love it.
Here's Galloway. He's guarded by McCollum. Galloway kicks to Brown. Here's Wood. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Milwaukee.
And they kept fouling him. I mean, it only made him more aggressive. He wound up having a huge night at the free throw line.
Costa Swanigan. Beyond the arc. Trent can't hit. We'll see if they want to trade 2-for-1 here.
Got to time up that clock to do so.
35 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Snell kicks to Brown. Just five to shoot. Top of the key. It's hauled in by Trent.
Now look, even if he had other places to go with the ball, that's a good shot. You can't blame him for letting that one fly.
Kept alive. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. The Trailblazers have gone 2-for-2 in the game at the line.
Shooting, and they've done some really nice work at the foul line, knocking down 80%.
Shooting two.
That free throw missing. One drops. He ties it up. Here's Galloway. Here's Henson. No good on that one. It's all tied in Portland. And the second quarter will get underway just after this short break.
on both ends.
You're exactly right, G.A. I mean, they've been quicker to the ball, showing great anticipation and terrific custom.
Now here's McCollum. They've got McCollum. Swanigan is out there with Little. And it's Trent in at the two-guard spot. That's the group in the game for the Trailblazers.
Well, he's a volume three-point shooter. McCollum looks to take this shot often for this very reason.
Brown finds Galloway. Back to Brown. Sweet little floater.
Oh, even from that range, the floater is one of the toughest shots in the game.
Portland leading. McCollum outside. Floats one. Rebound by the Pistons.
A fantastic effort on D to get up in his face and deny the layup.
Quarter number two. We're about a minute in. Galloway. The Pistons rebound. Here's Wood. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Here's Trent. He's covered by Brown. Out left to the wing. Jacks up a three. They get it again. Swanigan gets the bucket. Swanigan's got 5 points so far.
Yeah, coach's pet peeve there. No box out.
Oh, it's simple. When you fail to put a body on someone, you're inviting a breakdown on the defensive backs.
Now, here's Brown. He's coming off a 16-point game against Milwaukee.
And not only that, I mean, if you think about it, he dominated the boards. His energy was incredible. He never stopped working.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Whiteside's checked in for the Trailblazers. And Fernie Simons comes in for C.J. McCollum. Morris is checked in for Detroit. Dumboya comes in for Langston Galloway. And Chris, one thing you have to like about Galloway is that he's always prepared to play.
Yeah, Galloway is the type of player that can see 5 minutes on the floor in one game and then start and play 25 minutes the next one. I mean, just think about that focus for consistency. The production can be hit or miss, but he's a great plug-and-play option for a coach in need of filling minutes.
As more and more we're seeing star players give their sneakers to fans at the end of games. Did you ever do that?
Oh, yeah, man. Especially when I was with Dada, I would give a pair of shoes away after every game.
Oh, great.
Really love doing it on the road. At home is really cool, but on the road is great because that's where you know that fan braved all those other fans and the elements to wear your jersey and to be the only one there. So you look for that kid. I used to look for the kid with the number 4 Weber jersey and be like, hey, kid, I know what you went through to wear that tonight. You make sure you go home with these bragging rights. Tell them these are fresh from the game when we beat your team, baby.
Yeah, that's a neat way to connect. So for the Trailblazers, their last game, a loss to the Pelicans.
Well, in that one, you could pretty much see the writing on the wall. Their performance was lackluster at best.
Greg, they just weren't ready for that game. It looked like they just weren't prepared. The final score tells you the story. Now, they've tailored their offense around him. And let me tell you, he loves playing in the system.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Dwayne Casey was the 2018 Coach of the Year, but as we all know, he was fired after that same season by the Raptors. Casey's found a home in Detroit. Casey said, I have no regrets. Winston Churchill said, success consists of going from failure to failure without losing enthusiasm. And that's what I've done. So, Kevin, Dwayne Casey is still pounding the rock.
I'm sure he is, and I like that Churchill quote as well. Thanks, David.
Has such a soft release. I mean, you love seeing the ball roll off his feet.
Portland again missing. For Detroit, they've gone 4 of 7 from the field in this second quarter so far. 13 feet away. Rose, no good. Portland's gone 1 of 3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. And the foul called on Markieff Morris. That is his first foul of the game. Pistons on defense. Whiteside gets to Ariza. The pass to Simons. Nice D from Rose. And so it's Rose who brings the ball up for Detroit. He's off on that one. And it's Portland the other way.
Just can't find the touch this quarter. He's got to keep grinding, though, and looking for the best shot possible.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high percentage looks from inside.
Pass to Mikhailiuk. To the wing on the left. Passes it to Rose. Morris outside. Nice ball movement by Detroit. Shot clock at 5. On its way from Rose for 2. No good off the back of the rim.
It's been a really tough quarter for him. I mean, he cannot get his shots to drop.
Here's Simons. He's covered by Rose. Right side, no good.
They haven't needed him as much as I thought they would tonight.
Mikhailiuk, and again it's the Pistons missing.
And if you ask me what percentage of the time he's making that shot, my answer would be in the single digits.
Yeah, that's not his spot, plain and simple. He's trying to force something. It's rarely a good idea.
Tony Snell's checked in for the Pistons. Simons surveying the D. Anthony, the pass to Simons. Portland again missing. The Pistons trailing.
And the Blazers, one of the best offenses in the league. I mean, their guards can make most any shot. And they've got some glass eaters to chase down any misses.
They get the rebound. Here's Whiteside. Good work defensively by Morris. Detroit's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Rose passes to Morris. And Whiteside sends it back. There's 1:54 left in the second quarter. The putback, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. And the Trailblazers lead by 3.
Yeah, and the presence of Whiteside in the paint, really unreal. He is a dominant figure down low. Great work to grab that second chance opportunity.
And now the Blazers. And then for Detroit, John Henson's checked in for Maker. Christian Wood comes in for Morris. And it's Bruce Brown in for Dumboyer. Rose can't hit.
He's gone off the rails this quarter. And it's a bad time to do it. I mean, but they're needing to fight from behind.
McCollum deciding where to go with it. Pass to Whiteside. Ariza outside. 5 on the clock. From outside the arc, Portland with a new 14. And Whiteside stays right with it. Whiteside's got the lead up to 5 now for the Trailblazers.
Oh, man, just beast mode on the glass there. He was not going to be denied on that play.
He's disappeared this quarter. He can't get anything to drop. That's not going to help him get out of the hole.
And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
And Chris, just how special was it to play for Detroit in your career? What relationship does this team have with their fans?
Yeah, it was so special. I mean, being able to go home to the house that I grew up in, or to where my parents lived, and be able to go to the Pistons practice and to be part of it, to put on that jersey. It was so special, man. This team is a mainstay of the city. I mean, you feel like you can lift up the whole city when you play for the Pistons. It was such a special part of my career. Yeah, the Blazers boasting one of the game's elite backcourts in Damian Lillard and C.J. McCollum. I mean, other than the Splash Brothers, these two have the most points and three-pointers of any duo over the last handful of seasons.
Little, he's checked in for Portland. So Anthony nails both of them. Pistons trail by 7. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Galloway kicks to Brown. Here's Henson. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. They get Hassan Whiteside. The Pistons have made 3 free throws so far. Haven't missed any.
And in terms of team numbers, the free throw percentage is right at 74.
first free throw is good. Henson hits them both. Trailblazers leading by five. Here's Simons. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
1 second separating the shot clock and game clock. Galloway with the bucket.
I mean, you got to respect the guts of Galloway. I mean, at 6'2", it's great to see him capitalize inside.
Brown against McCollum. Let's it go from deep. No good on the last second attempt there. And that's it for the first half of action. What's been a very close game here. Portland out in front, up by three. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks. Coach, it's been a grinded out game. What have you seen from your team so far?
Well, we're competing. You know, neither team's really shooting the ball that well, but both teams are playing hard.
Energy always leads to good results. Thanks, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is right here. Say hey to the folks, Kenny.
Hey, folks.
Say hey to the folks, Shaq.
Hey, folks.
Hey, let's get this party started. The first quarter for the Trailblazers was fairly even. Nothing seemed to give way on either side of the scoring column as they wrapped up the period all knotted up. They battled hard in the second quarter, and it was reflected on the scoreboard. What'd you think about Portland, Kenny?
So far, I love their commitment on the glass. Even when they were playing well, their rebounding remained a priority. And so far, the other side hasn't matched their efforts.
And Shaq, what are your thoughts on Detroit?
Well, I didn't even know who some of these guys were, but their bench came up with some big shots, gave the team a lift offensively. It's always possible those guys will see more minutes in the second half, but at the same time, you're a starter for a reason. We shall see, Ernie.
And that's all we have for now. Tell the folks goodbye, Shaq. Tell the folks goodbye,
goodbye.
Kenny. Goodbye. Go to Kevin Harlan.
Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game it's been so far. You look at Hassan Whiteside in this game. Guys, he's everywhere.
And he was an absolute monster on the offensive glass in that first half. I don't know how you slow him down.
Yeah, you must try to match his energy level first and foremost. But right now, he's just out hustling guys to the floor.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. And so it's McCollum. He'll bring it up for the Portland Trailblazers. 3-point lead. And Detroit, looking at who they've got. They've got Tony Snell. Dumboya is out there with Maker. And it's Rose. And it's Mekhi Luke in at the two.
You got to know McCollum is looking to fire off the pass. This is why you must play up on.
Here's the pass to Mekhi Luke. Pocket six, pass to Dumboya. Puts up a three, the offensive rebound, and it'll go. And the Blazer lead is cut down to four on the bucket from Maker.
At 7'1", you got to box out Maker because he's capable of burning you on the offensive glass.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, in Blake Griffin, the Pistons have their biggest star in years, probably going back to their championship team of 2004. A return to all-star form for Blake meant tremendous individual numbers last season. The Pistons hadn't won a playoff game in more than a decade. Still not the result they want in 2019. The Pistons will be trying to capitalize during Blake's prime. Kevin, we'll see where this franchise goes from here.
He sure will, David, but he's a terrific player. Thank you so much.
And so difficult to contain Rose off the pick and roll. It creates opportunities all over the floor.
McCollum, rebound, Detroit. Here's Mikhailov. No points in the game yet for him. From a pure entertainment standpoint, who's a player that you think is must-watch TV?
Oh, man, you got to go Curry, Lillard, Harden, Giannis, Embiid, Simmons.
I mean,
you could just keep going. Let's go Lou Will off the bench. Let's even go defensively. You can even go Patrick Beverley. So many guys that is just so much fun to watch play. Must-see TV.
And he makes the first. The Trailblazers making a switch here. Swanigan's checked in. So 1-for-2 that time at the stripe.
You look back at the Blake Griffin trade. Many thought the Pistons gave up too much, but it's worked out for them.
Yeah, losing the picks for Griffin, you have to admit, it did hurt. But people forget that Griffin is a star player, and he reminded those same people last year. He's become the leader for this franchise as they try to move forward.
Here's a reason. Following the score by Derrick Rose. Reza passes to Simon. A three-pointer, no good. The Pistons have gone 3-of-5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Here's Rose. Makes it off the glass. Rose has got 12.
Yeah, that's exactly how you want to utilize Rose at the point guard position. Run him off screens all night long.
Simons, the pass to Anthony. This one for three. Out of bounds, Detroit takes possession.
And checking out the numbers for C.J. McCollum.
He's been more than solid over the last month. He's putting up about 21 points per, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. To have a scorer like him consistently deliver you points makes such a big difference for a team.
Yeah, it gives you something you really can rely on going into every game. And you can also work off of him to look to create for others.
It's Carmelo Anthony on the wing. Wide open shot is on the money. And the Trailblazers lead by 1.
And the shooting form of Anthony, just perfect. He's dangerous with the catch and shoot and just terrific at scoring when in rhythm.
Now, here's Dumboyer. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. Maker kicks to Snell. Detroit needs to get off his shot. And the basket by Maker.
Timeout.
He's got 8.
A sharp weapon for Maker, active in trying to get himself going from beyond the arc.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. Players who have been dominant on the glass for the past 10 games and counting. Fifth is Sekou Doumbouya.
He's been playing some very determined basketball here lately. It's showing in those rebounding numbers.
Here's Trent. He's covered by Brown. It's stolen by Brown. And here's Rose. 12 points for him. To the inside. And there's Morris. That's good on the assist by Rose. Now it's a 4-point Detroit lead. And so it's McCollum. He'll bring it up for Portland. Here's Trent. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Here's Ariza. And Maker sends it back.
Proving he could be an active defender. Great hustle from Maker to stifle the shooter.
Here's Doumbouya. And he banks in the layup. Doumbouya's got the lead up to 6 now for the Pistons.
And there's been a drop-off in their defense since halftime. I mean, they don't nearly have the same energy they did in the first half.
Trent passes to McCollum. Here's Swanigan. Portland, no good that time either.
Come on, you got to get up on him and play some defense. They won't get away with that next time.
Brown dishes to Rose. Pass to Doumbouya. Morris right side. And no good that time. Good D by Ariza.
And it's easy to see why a team would want Ariza on their roster. Makes the right decision, mentors young players, and is well respected throughout the league.
Here's Dumboya following the basket by CJ McCollum. Dumboya with it. 6 points for him. Just 5 to shoot. And another 3 for Detroit.
Not everything fell for him in that first half, and now it looks like they're beginning to hit their stride.
Pass to Swanigan. And, oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Second shot opportunity. Morris with the rebound.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Brown outside to the paint, and Morris throws it down.
Wow, the size of Morris helps him down low, especially when he decides to sky high for the dunk.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Now a timeout called by Portland.
And 6 straight playoff appearances for the Blazers under Terry Stotts. Last season making the Western Conference Finals.
Yeah, G.A., and he was rewarded with the multi-year contract extension. He's done a great job developing their young players while also having them compete at a high level.
John Henson's checked in for Thon Maker. Christian Wood comes in for Morris. And Langston Galloway subbed in for Derrick Rose. Now, here's Whiteside. He's got 8. 1:22 left in the third quarter. Back to McCollum. 6 on the shot clock. Releases from the wing and drills it. McCollum's got 14.
And since halftime, he has been a different player.
And there's the pass to Dumboya. Back to Galloway. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. There's 45 seconds left of the third. Now here's McCollum. D right on him. Here's Dumboya. And the jam by Dumboya.
He is a fantastic athlete for a power forward. Whatever he lacks in height, he makes up for with hops.
Pass to Trent. The 3. And Galloway pulls it down. Pistons leading by 9.
And no need to rush this. Let the clock run down.
Yeah, no need to give the ball back here. You want to close this quarter with momentum.
Here's McCollum. Rebounded by the Pistons. Deep, and he was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall. And so is Detroit ahead by 9 as the quarter comes to a close. And it's been their rugged defense setting the tone. We come back right after this. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
And how about the floor generalship right here? I mean, showing us why they're always in good hands when he's the man in charge.
Great vision. He's a gifted passer. Has his finger on the pulse of this offense.
And this is it. Glad to have you along for this fourth and final quarter. Pistons leading by 9. At the 2 and the 3, McCollum and Little. Whiteside is out there with Anthony. And it's Simons in at the 5. That's the group on the floor for Portland. Here's Mikhailiuk. To the middle. Teardrop shot. And Whiteside sends it back. They retain possession. And it's Brown missing. And here are the Trailblazers now. Inside. Anthony's shot is off.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
Well, that's why he's out there right now. In situations like this, he stands tall to prevent points.
Here's Galloway. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. Galloway has got the lead up to 11 now for the Pistons. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Passes to Wood, and stolen by Whiteside. McCollum outside. A floater. That shot off. The Pistons go the other way with it. Brown the pass to Mikhailiuk. Pass to Henson. Over Whiteside. Henson's shot is off.
Even when the D is playing off of a mid-range jumper, shouldn't be the shot they're looking for.
And so Galloway with it. He'll bring it up for the Detroit Pistons. Here in the fourth quarter, their defense has been very strong, allowing no baskets. A moment now to see how the schedule is looking for Detroit. On Tuesday, they'll be taking on Paul Millsap and the Denver Nuggets. And then on Friday, they continue the road trip, heading out to Phoenix to take on the Suns.
Take a break. And Kevin, you have to look at this as an opportunity to take a step forward. Sometimes tough road trips can bring the best out of a team and bring you closer together.
And the first one drops. Tony Snell's checked in for Langston Galloway. One falls, so he hits both of them. Here's Simons. Back in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Terry Stotts went over with his team. And he was emphatic. He said, "We are not going to win this game playing this way, fellas. You've got to step it up. You've got to get aggressive. And you've got to battle to get back in this thing." See if that pep talk got him going, guys.
And he gets it to go.
I wouldn't want to be the guy who has to keep him off the boards. He is a beast on the offensive boards.
Now the pass to Henson. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Shooting for Detroit, John Henson. Taking two shots.
Shooting two.
That's good from Henson. Henson hits them both. Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Here's McCollum. 18 feet away, and he knocks it down.
You got to respect the intelligence of McCollum. A thrower utilizing the pick and roll. You can't let him get into a comfort zone.
Pass to Mikhailiuk. Lets it go from deep, and the foul on John Henson. That's his first foul.
He's just stretching him out. The defense has got to do a better job of staying attached to him.
Yeah, I mean, that's not a guy you can leave alone. Not if you have any hope of closing the gap.
Akers checked in for Detroit. Rose comes in for Bruce Brown. We're in the final quarter of play here, 3 minutes in. Cullen passes a little. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum.
Kevin, great court awareness from the crafty guard McCollum. I mean, a good teammate who likes hitting his open guys.
Here's Snell. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Snell's got his first 2 points.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Yeah, they're pouring it on right here. Trying to give the opposition no light at the end of the tunnel.
Simons, the pass to Carmelo. No good from outside.
He has shot them in the foot with his inability to make shots tonight.
And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Yeah, easy call.
Tony Snell. Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Trevor Ariza's checked in for a little. Both good from the line that time.
And that's another area where he is just a superb player. Excellent at the free throw line.
Anthony dishes to McCollum. Here's Simons. Off target on the 15-footer.
Well, until he starts knocking down some shots, I don't think the deficit's going to get any smaller.
2 points. That one goes.
And that's the Derrick Rose of old. Full speed ahead and bursting to the rim.
Passes it to Ariza. Right through the D for the layup. Pistons leading by 15. Rose with the ball. Now Anthony defending. And it's blocked by Whiteside. And here we go. Trailblazers with a fast break. Simons, the pass to Whiteside. Rebounded by the Pistons. Woods got 6 rebounds now in the game. Mikhailuk can't get it to go.
He's done a lot of the little things to help put them in front. I mean, but his offense has not been there for tonight.
And it's Rose with the ball for the Pistons. It's Wood, top of the key. Right wing. Here's Mikhailuk. Buries it from 3-point range. And the Pistons lead by 18.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
But it's a lazy effort. Let's just be honest. Hoping the shooter misses, that doesn't constitute defense.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over.
The rim and put the D in some tough spots and also finishing strong.
He took charge tonight, and it was just that type of breakout performance they needed. As they try to shake out of the slump they've been in, they'll be hoping he has more nights and in just like this one. Now, here's Whiteside. Trailblazers moving the ball around. Here's Simons. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Front pass the arc. Trailblazers keep it alive.
And they get it back again. I mean, how many rebounds offensively have they had? Everything's going right for them today.
Now, here's Rose. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Rose has got 4 points now in the quarter.
Late in the game, up big, they continue to attack.
And it's not about running up the score. It's about closing the door on any kind of comeback. He'll do some damage if they give him that shot. Don't give him a clean look. Get out there on him.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for the Pistons.
I think the attitude was very impressive. definitely a competitive game, and they fought through it each step of the way.
Absolutely. They put on a tremendous performance in terms of the effort and intensity. This was a well-deserved win.
And a milestone win for the season. This will push their victory total to 20 wins even.
And so they'll take the first game of the season series, a team they'll only see twice. They're certainly happy to start it off with a win.
And you know, guys, what a nice performance it was for Rose.
His passes were crisp tonight, pinpoint. So many easy buckets came off his assist.
Here's Trent. 52 seconds left to play here in the fourth.
You can appreciate the fight now, but it isn't how they came into the game.
Yeah, how they ended this one is much different than how they started it, and that's a shame.
Morris inside. Nifty move to the left side wing. Releases. Gabriel with the rebound. The Blazers on offense. Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Here's Horde. The Trailblazers need to get off a shot. Releases. No good there off the double clutch. And so Detroit takes this one by a big margin. And in the win, a comfortable win in what was, I think, a pretty hostile environment.
It really was. You know, it's never going to be easy on the road, but they didn't have too many problems with that tonight.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Alford, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.